Hey everyone, how you doing? This is Robbert from Raw Travel TV, and I'm here today to talk to you about my friends Abeta from Ethio-USA and Mulageta from Pathfinder Tours. In the summer of 2019, I finally, after many, many years, got to visit Ethiopia. And a lot of that was due to my friends at Ethio-USA and Pathfinder Tours. I had met a friend from Ethiopia many, many years ago, and I actually had lost touch with her, but I remembered the conversation we had about her country. And since then, I had been paying attention when other people went, and I was just so curious about it, and I was so excited to go in 2019. And let me tell you, I was not disappointed. What I loved about dealing with Ethio-USA and Pathfinder Tours was Abeta here in the U.S. was organizing things and in conversation with Mulageta there in Ethiopia. From the moment we arrived, we had, you know, a schedule and agenda, as we're prone to do, filming. And we had allocated some time to spend in the northern part of the country, which I would say is probably the most popular spot to go because it has a lot of the religious sites that you've seen on shows like 60 Minutes, Lalibela, Axum. They were just amazing. I had never seen such history on display, and I had such just an amazing time there. The people were wonderful. The sites were amazing. It was just one site after another after another. But the real mind-blowing part of the trip for me was when we went down south with the tribes of southern Ethiopia. I'd never had that experience before. I don't know if I'll ever have it again, but we were able to see three different tribes in southern Ethiopia, all extremely unique and different. And thanks to Mulageta Pathfinder Tours, knowing those folks and being able to be a conduit between us, we really got not only context about the tribe and some information about them before we went in, but we were welcomed with open arms by the people in the tribe. And that really helped us a lot. That has to be, hands down, one of my most memorable experiences ever, was just hanging out with each of those tribes, in particular, the Mercy and the Hammer tribe. It was amazing, amazing, amazing. And then the last part of the trip, we hung out in Addis Ababa. I spent a lot of time there solo, but I had the support of Mulageta as well. And there we were able to hang out with and do some things on a voluntourism basis with Magabi Skate, which is a great organization by a friend of mine, Izzy. Izzy grew up in a neighborhood called Shirometa. And if you've watched the show, you've seen what they do. They have, Shirometa is a very poor neighborhood, but they've built skateboard ramps. They brought in skateboards. There's no skateboarding outlets in Ethiopia, but they brought that for the young people to keep them out of trouble. And it's not just for boys. His sister heads up Magabi Skate Girls, and they're just a wonderful organization. They have monthly events in Shirometa called Dream Big Events, where there's music, poetry, art, all the community gets together, and of course, skateboarding. And if you happen to be in Addis Ababa when that's going on, I highly encourage you to do that. I know that Ethio-USA, they can help you do that. Another organization that I really bonded with was Intoto Beth Artisan. And they work with the ladies of the Intoto region, which is on the mountain top. And basically, Intoto Beth Artisan works with HIV-infected women to make jewelry, fair trade artifacts, and things like that. HIV-infected women are often stigmatized in Ethiopia, unfortunately. And so these guys provide job opportunities for them. And they do really creative stuff with their jewelry. For example, turning used bullet casings into jewelry. And not just jewelry, but other types of souvenirs as well. So I highly recommend hitting up their shop in Addis Ababa, or if you get lucky, you may even be able to go to the workshop where they make this stuff. Either way, I think if you are thinking of, like, where can I travel after the pandemic? I'm just so pent up. I really want a major trip. Ethiopia rings that bell. It was one of my favorite trips of all time. I really enjoyed my time there. You know, it's challenging. It's not, you're not going to Disney World. You're going to a developing country. But the people are incredible, the food is excellent, and because it's challenging, that's why I really recommend that, you know, unless you're just a real seasoned independent, you know, go it alone traveler, that you get someone like Ethio-USA and Pathfinder Tours, because they're going to help smooth out those rough spots and make sure that everything's taken care of And I had a great time, no regrets. My only regret would have been if I hadn't have gone, and I hope I get a chance to go back and dig even deeper.